Today, we are using the Rise of Kingdoms application for PC. This is currently in beta testing, so a lot of people are still new to this application, and there are some bugs and there are some kinks to it. So today, for those users and those future users, if you are going to be using this application, I want to tell you, it runs very smooth, and I really like it. But there's a few differences between this app and, of course, with the previous application that we are using called BlueStacks. In today's video, we're going to help you also, if you're still having that verification issue when you're using this application, I'm also going to tell you how you can fix that. And the second thing as well, there's frequently asked questions that we're going to be answering as well. And third thing is, of course, the controls. There's slight differences of controls in here versus BlueStacks. So it's definitely something that you want to know and you want to watch until the end. My name is Shinchi42. I hope that this video will be very helpful and that you will enjoy the Rise of Kingdoms application that is still in beta testing. So the downloading for this application is very limited. There's only a certain amount of players who is going to be able to do the beta testing. Now, if you want to download it, I'll put the link in the description and also a link for BlueStacks if you want to play Rise of Kingdoms on PC and you could not get the application version 1. Now, if you guys missed out, that's really because you were not updated. So make sure that you join our Discord. There's also TikTok, which I have been posting there. So if you have a TikTok and you want to get updated right away, follow our TikTok because we upload videos there as well. All right, guys, if this video does help you out, make sure to leave us a like. All right, first thing, we're going to answer this question from our friend, from Apostle of Christ. Will PC players be able to play against mobile players? Yes, they can definitely play against each other. So some of the players in here are still mobile gamers, and I am playing this on PC. It's just similar with BlueStacks when we were using BlueStacks. So another term for this is that it's cross-platform. What Rise of Kingdoms have done is they have cross-platform between PC and mobile. All right, so that's relatively cool and how they have developed this, honestly. Second question in here, how is it going to impact their game versus our game? Because they have distinct advantage to us in PC because they have more controls. So the biggest advantage that I can definitely see currently right now is the movement. So when I was playing on, you know, on my BlueStacks, I definitely have an advantage when it comes to movement, when it comes to targeting, and of course, playing on your PC, it's going to be less laggier on your game. So that's another thing that I want to highlight. Playing it on PC, regardless with this app, or if you're using BlueStacks, there's going to be less lag if you have a very good computer. So everything really depends on what type of device you have or what type of equipment you have. And I take my old account and put it on PC if I wish to get a PC version. Yes, you can. It just needs to be linked with Facebook. So if you have an old account that is linked on Facebook and you want to bring it in here, yes, you can definitely do that. So you can definitely get your old account and logged in into this new application. Will the interface for mobile players change better match the PC experience? Honestly, I think it's relatively the same. I don't think there's any issue with the interface. The interface is same with PC and same with mobile. Will there be a version of the game which is only available to PC gamers? And only certain game instances for PC game. No, there's really no. Like I said, this is just cross-platform. So there's really no difference between PC gamers and mobile gamers. We're still in one server, your kingdom, and that's pretty much it. The only thing is difference in here, we're playing on your mobile or your tablet versus playing on computer with your keyboard and mouse. Or maybe if you have a touchscreen computer, then you can definitely use touchscreen computer as well. All right, a few more questions in here before we get into controls. All right, so chats. Is the chat working with emojis? So currently, the emojis are not working yet. So as you can see, it's still in beta testing, so they are going to be fixing all of this. There's also a few things that actually is missing in the chat. The emoji section in here. Photos, the voice chat, it's not here yet. It's not applicable yet. You can't also tag. So if I click at, you cannot tag anybody as well. So that's another thing that is an issue yet that hasn't been fixed yet. Since it's day one or it's day two now, rest assured that Rise of Kingdoms is going to be fixing all of these kinks in here. Now, the issue that players have been having, the verification. Yes. So I believe for what I heard is that they're already fixing this. If you want to get updated, you have to go to the Rise of Kingdoms official Discord. So to bypass the verification reward, what you got to do is if you're stuck there in the verification reward here, actually, I want to see to kind of test it out to see if it's having some finicky still. See, like this, I'm going to verify it and I'm going to be stuck here. All right. It's not working. So majority players are actually experiencing this. I don't know how many players are having this issue right now with this verification reward. You must simply just really log in onto your phone. And I'm going to show you this right now. I'm logging into my game in here. I'm going to get disconnected here. All right. Since this is still in one game, you are already logged onto another device. Now, what I'm going to do is I am going to do my verification reward in my phone. So I'm going to just clean this up real quick. So I'm going to finish that up. All right. Once I have finished that up, now I'm going to click log in here. The issue in here is that it also crashes the game when you do that. So we're getting back into the game. And the verification should be done. I should not have this verification waiting for me anymore. So I think we have another question in here. iPhone to PC. I don't have an Apple product, so I don't know if it would work, but I think it should since this is a downloadable content directly as an application. I don't think there is a restriction in here. So I think Apple users will be able to play this game under, like, you know, if you have a Mac or, you know, MacBook Pro, iMac, all of that stuff, you should be able to download this application from Rise of Kingdoms. And you should be able to play this on your computer. Another question. Can you play without Facebook? All right. So without Facebook, I don't think you can. One of the rules was you have to be bound to Facebook. Now, the reason why for that is that that's their verification system, right, for validity. Another thing is that you can't log in with your Google Play anymore since this is not under Google. Or you cannot log in with your iOS anymore. Right, or your Apple Center or Apple Play, because this is not under Apple anymore. This is independent from Lilith Games. So this is an application independent with them, all right? So I think it's absolutely very interesting. There's a few kinks that I've experienced in here, like a little bit of a lag of delay of collecting some of the items. Like earlier when we first logged in, I was kind of having some issue there. So far, It's a very interesting application within the game. So another thing that people have told me is that the application itself runs on GPU rather than CPU. So apparently there's some issue with running in GPU and running on CPU. I'm not no computer expert in here. So if you guys have a lot more information, I would definitely love for you guys to explain all of this in here. The dumbest way you can, because I'm no computer expert. So I just know, hey, it works. There's no lag. You know, I buy the expensive computer. It's good. It's working. And then I'm good, right? So that's the kind of gamer I am. I haven't built my own computer yet. Maybe one day I will. And I will definitely learn a few more things about computers. So just take it for what I said in here. I don't really exactly know what specs. So at least somebody said if you have at least 6 GB of RAM, you should be fine. But I think that's different from what we have just said from previous statements. So I'm not so sure. So just kind of read through the comments and hopefully people are going to leave comments when it comes to specification for this application. But honestly, in my opinion, just in a basic term, but I think if you have your college laptop, they should run this, because when I have my college laptop, you know, I was running with i7 back then. That was like 4 years ago. I was running and playing like Dota 2. I mean, that was running really well without lag, but this is Rise of Kingdoms. It's a mobile game. It shouldn't be that laggy, in my opinion, when you're running it on your computer. So there's that. So hopefully that's actually helpful. Now let's get into controls. Now to get into controls, there's a few things that you definitely want to know, right? Zoom in and zoom out. So to zoom in, you got to do your scroll. So your mouse, right? You just do scroll up and down. And another thing that you can do is you can do right click. You can drag it. Follow my mouse. You can drag it. All right. It's zooming in, zooming out. So another thing that I want to highlight is that when you're looking into this, right? If I wanted to specifically target this ruins, I go zoom in and zoom out using my scroll, right? So you can see it's directly going down to the target. So this is relatively similar to BlueStacks in here. So this is BlueStacks that I am using. So a few differences, right? You can see that the chat is slightly different because we have these things. So currently within the app, we don't have these buttons. To zoom in and zoom out within the app, you cannot use your scroll. You actually have to do control, or you can actually use the up and down arrow. Now I'm gonna sneak this information in here. The difference between these two, right? One is BlueStacks application, right? It's a company. And another thing with BlueStacks is that you can run multi-instance. So like for this one, I have a multi-instance where I can run multiple BlueStacks open, multiple Gmails account open, and I can run multiple accounts. So that's a, you know, a great thing about BlueStacks and one of the reasons why I play with BlueStacks. Now, here's a big thing about this one. Is that not everybody has the capability to purchase. Not everybody has the money to purchase device. So BlueStacks allows you to have multiple devices under one computer. Now, when you're downloading Rise of Kingdoms, you can only run one account in the Rise of Kingdoms app, right? I don't know if you can create another whole new window screen and run it over there. Perhaps you can do that and you can run multiple accounts and open multiple accounts with different, you know, I don't know what's the right term for this. Like you boot up another Windows or boot up another like Mac window or whatever it is. So that's another thing that you need to definitely consider when you're picking both of this. But honestly, it runs really smooth. Another thing is that, so if you want to go for full screen or not full screen, so I'm actually on the not full screen right now. You can do is click out plus enter. So now I'm on full screen. I'm on not full screen. I'm on full screen, not on full screen. So alt plus enter will allow you to get into full screen. If you want to close the game, you just definitely do alt F4, which I'm not going to do right now. But if you want to close it, if it froze, you want to close it, you press alt F4. Another thing that you can do is that if you want to open up the, you know, the chats in here, you can do shift T for the chat, shift T. All right, shift T opens chats. So shift E allows you to expand and minimize the selection bar in here within your chat. So if you want to close the chat, again, shift T. And if you want to minimize and maximize, you can definitely do with shift E. Now, you might be struggling in the war. So if you're in battle, you're in war, and you want to cancel it, how do you cancel it? All right, in BlueStacks, you will just press the up arrow, right? On BlueStacks, it would cancel with the up arrow. Now, okay, I'm stuck in here. I don't know what to do. I don't want to attack this, right? I'm going, okay, you can do that. You can cancel by dragging it out. But let's say you don't want to do this function. What you want to do to cancel this march is you simply press right click and now it's canceled. So you should just try that. So marching in here, I don't want to attack this. I click right click. Now it's canceled. The action is now canceled. So the action that you want to do is now being canceled. So just got to press right click on that. So if you got more questions in here, leave it down in the comment section below. Join the Discord. You can message us on TikTok as well. Leave a comment in. It's a lot faster for me to reply there as well on TikTok, but I can definitely reply on you guys in here in the comment section below. So make sure to join Discord because that's so important. Link is in the description. You cannot miss out on that one. So all the information you need will be where? Will be on the description below. Anyway, Rockers, I hope this is helpful. And good luck to you guys. And I really think this is really fun. I'm glad that there is this, you know, Rise of Kingdoms application. I'm very excited to see if we're going to see very minimal lag on KVK Wars. Anyway, Rockers, I'll see you again next time.